Welcome to the Ira A. Fulton Schools of Engineering at Arizona State University. Our college houses the undergraduate and graduate degree programs for engineering, computer science, and a majority of the technology programs that are offered at ASU. This presentation will explore the mechanical engineering degree program with a concentration in energy and the environment. ASU has four campuses that span the Phoenix metro area, and the Fulton Schools of Engineering are located on two of those, the Tempe campus and the Polytechnic campus. The degree programs within the School for Engineering of Matter, Transport, and Energy, also known as SEMPTE, are located at the Tempe campus, but all campuses are open to all students regardless of where their program is located. We offer a free intercampus shuttle for our students so that they can explore courses, student orgs, activities, and resources at any campus. At Fulton, we offer 25 undergraduate degree programs, which provides a lot of choice and flexibility in finding the program that fits for you. We are called the Fulton Schools of Engineering because we categorize our degree programs into six schools, which are organized by theme and location. The first five schools from left to right are housed at the Tempe campus, and the Polytechnic School is housed at the Polytechnic campus. Our mechanical engineering students belong to the School for Engineering of Matter, Transport, and Energy, which you will see towards the right of the infographic. Each school has its own director, affiliated faculty, and advising unit so as to provide greater support and specific guidance to the students within that school. ASU and Fulton have direct admission, meaning when students apply, they apply directly to the degree program they want to pursue. As long as a student meets the admissions criteria for their program of interest, they are admitted. It is important to note that some of the degree programs, including mechanical engineering, have slightly higher admissions criteria than the general university requirements. For a comprehensive list of admissions criteria, you can visit the Fulton Schools of Engineering website at engineering.asu.edu. Students in SEMPTE are located at the Tempe campus, which is both their academic and residential home. First-year freshmen are expected to live on campus their first year, and our SEMPTE students are currently registering for housing in the Tooker House. Tooker House is the residential hall for all of the engineering disciplines, and we are also expanding to the University House for the 2020-2021 academic year. Students that are part of Barrett the Honors College live in Barrett housing, but are given the opportunity to live on an engineering-specific floor if they choose.
The concentration in energy and environment within the BSE in mechanical engineering is designed to prepare students to analyze technical problems in air pollution, climate change, energy efficiency, environmental sustainability, renewable energy, and timely issues facing the global community. Choosing the energy and environment concentration lets students focus on renewable energy, air pollution, and sustainability. Although the primary focus of this program is technical, the general education courses in the area of the humanities and social behavioral sciences introduces students to the global, political, and societal issues relating to energy and environment. By focusing on issues such as air pollution, water scarcity, and the lack of alternative transportation, this program is even more attractive for employers in the greater Phoenix area as well as nationwide. Students in the undergraduate program get to cultivate an understanding behind a diverse range of operations while developing the skills needed to produce hands-on results for their community and abroad. As you can see on the major map, the mechanical engineering with a concentration in energy and environment is 120 credits, much of which is math or science-based. Students in this program take Calculus 1, 2, and 3, as well as differential equations and elementary linear algebra. Students also take chemistry and physics 1 and 2. In the second year is when students start taking mechanical engineering courses. The prefix for these are MAE and MEE. The first year is general education courses to provide a solid foundation for this program. Students are required to take 15 credits of humanities or social behavioral courses. As students move into the second half of the program, they will get to choose their technical elective courses as well as energy technical electives, which allow students to branch off in areas of interest. The accelerated degree, often referred to as the 4+1, allows students to share up to 12 credits between graduate and undergraduate programs, allowing students to complete a master's degree in 1 year. This saves students time and money and eliminates the need for the graduate readiness exam also known as the GRE. This program allows students to choose from a master's in mechanical engineering, aerospace engineering, or material science and engineering. Students apply for this program when they are completing MAE 318, MEE 342, and MEE 323, and must have a 3.5 GPA in all courses applying to their degree audit report. The Mechanical Engineering with Energy and Environmental Concentration offers opportunities to impact technological advances through working in a team environment with engineers from material science, electrical, chemical, aerospace, and other engineering disciplines. Students in this program are in demand in a wide range of industries and professions, including aerospace, automotive, biomedical, environmental, and power plant.
Hello everyone, my name is Madison Walker. I'm a current senior studying mechanical engineering on the Tempe campus, born and raised in Phoenix, Arizona. So I'd first like to mention that I don't have the concentration in energy and environment. However, I certainly wish I would have added this concentration if I had learned of it sooner. Many of the projects I've worked on, as well as my own career aspirations, align with what this program prepares students for. So I'll first give you a brief overview of my student org experience, and then I'll move on to talk about how this concentration can be helpful in real life projects. Some of the programs that I'm involved in are listed there on the slide, one of those being Fulton Ambassadors. I'm the current president of Fulton Ambassadors here on the Tempe campus. I'm also an active member of the Society of Women Engineers, the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, and the Next Generation Service Corps at ASU. All of these programs, one way or another, have helped me develop as an engineer and have helped me explore different things that I'm passionate about. Fulton Ambassadors focuses on K-12 engineering education and outreach, and that's been really, really exciting for me because I get to see how my own experiences can be shared with others and inspire them to pursue engineering. It's been a very fulfilling experience for me. As a member of the Society of Women Engineers, I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of other female engineering students that are very like-minded to me. And it's also allowed for me to have conversations with those that aren't in this female engineering community about what it means to be a female engineer. I think it's important to be involved in a diversity organization because diversity is very important in engineering. And what's amazing about SWE is we also have a lot of different industry connections. So I've had the opportunity to meet female engineers from Honeywell and Intel and Texas Instruments and really learn from their experiences to help shape me as an engineer. As a member of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, I've had the opportunity to compete in a team competition where we had to design a hovercraft made primarily out of 3D printed materials. This hovercraft had to simulate delivering care packages in times of natural disaster. So in ASME, not only have I learned and gained those technical skills of 3D printing, but I've also learned of what it means to be a mechanical engineer and what you can do to actually give back to the community. I chose engineering because I wanted to make an impact on society and I wanted to use a technical expertise to do that. And this experience with ASME has allowed for me to do that. Additionally, the Next Generation Service Corps has allowed for me to explore other things that I'm passionate about and really narrow in on one focus. NGSC is something that isn't specific to Fulton, it's actually ASU-wide. And in this program, you get to develop professionally, you develop leadership, and you also get to work with people that are outside of your specific discipline. So in working with students that are in marketing or design or in different sciences or sustainability, it's allowed for me to look at my passion and form the environment and really see different ways that I can approach this problem. And one of the great ways to do that is by getting involved in classes that will give me that, that knowledge. In this concentration of energy and environment, you have the opportunity to take classes that are in that relate to energy and environment in the humanities. You get to take technical electives, specifically for mechanical engineers. So I think it's definitely a great opportunity if that's something that you're interested in. I know that if I had learned of this program sooner, I definitely would have had that official stamp. But since I learned about it a little too late, I decided to take some classes that would allow for me to explore that a little more. So I'm currently in a class called Energy in the Global Arena that's offered in this concentration. It's a humanities course, and it's taught me a lot about energy and how it's impacted history and how it's impacted politics. And I think it's important to have that perspective and see this problem from a different lens. Additionally, I've gotten to take some technical classes that relate to what I'm passionate about, one of those being renewable energy. I'm in a renewable energy class right now, and it's really exciting because I get to learn about the different forms of renewable energy and what I can do as a mechanical engineer to contribute to that. Right now, my team and I are working on a final project where we're trying to understand how different government corporations use waves to actually generate energy. And this is great because obviously the ocean is a renewable resource. So we're trying to figure out mechanically how the waves to spin the turbines, what's the best location for it, if these turbines have any impact on the animal life, if microplastics in the water can affect these systems in any way. So it's a really, really awesome experience. And if any of the stuff that I've talked about sounds interesting to you, I highly encourage you to take this degree with this concentration, because not only are you going to be prepared for these kinds of things, but it's not too specific. If you are taking these classes and you realize that you might want to go a different route, you can still go into automotive engineering and biomedical engineering with this understanding and this background. But this program would definitely set you apart from other students.
Thank you for taking this time to explore the Ira A. Fulton Schools of Engineering. If you have any questions about applying to Fulton, please contact us at fultonschools@asu.edu. If you have any specific questions about the degree program covered in this presentation, please contact us at sempd@asu.edu.